各位大家好，欢迎收看今天英文翻译第十次播出。我们今天要谈英汉语言的对比第二部分。首先介绍跟我一块主持节目的 Charles 老师。Hi Charles。
各位观众，欢迎收看。Let's get started.
OK， 我们看看今天的翻译原理 ，Principles of Translation。上次我们做了英汉语言的对比，我们做了名词跟形容词。今天的英汉语言的对比，我们想谈一谈英汉的动词、副词还有冠词的差异。那么英汉动词，它最明显的差异有三点，我跟同学们说明。第一点是英语动词有及物动词跟不及物动词，我们叫 transitive verb 跟 intransitive verb。那么汉语呢，则多数都是及物动词。第二个区分是，每一个句子当中，英文它都是有一个定式的动词，叫 finite verb。可是汉语呢，每一个句子中间可以连续使用数个动词，就所谓的动词连用。第三点，我们要看英语动词表时式的时候，这 tense 的时候，它都是用有过去式的、现在式还有未来式，它用动词的变化叫语法的方式，譬如有 do、有 did、有 done。那我们汉语动词它表示时态的时候呢，它是利用一些词汇的方式，譬如用去年、现在或者明年等等来表示时间的词。好，现在我们来举些例子来说明看看这些差异。我们先看看及物动词 VT 跟不及物动词 VI 的例子。英语中及物动词可以直接连接受词，那不及物动词它多半要加一个介系词再连接受词。我们汉语呢，多数都是及物动词。我们看看句子。我们已讨论过这个主题，这是一个讨论过东西，用个及物动词。英文呢
？We discussed the subject。
好，这 discussed 它也是及物动词，后面直接接了 the subject。我们看下一句，谁都可以申请那项奖学金。我们中文里面申请后面就直接叫受词那项奖学金，但是英文怎么说呢
？Anyone can apply for the scholarship。
好，这个 apply 它是不及物，要加个 for 哈，才能接 the scholarship， 就有差别了哈。好，现在我们看一个定式动词与动词连用。英语中每个句子它只能使用一个定式动词，那么汉语句中的连用动词翻成英语的时候，我们多半都是只需要一个动词，其他动词要转换成不定词、动名词、介词、动词、分词等等其他的词类。我们举例说明，他努力试图成为一个成功的商人。
He tried very hard to become a successful businessman.
好，第一个动词是 tried， 后面这个 to become 你要加 to， 把它变成不定词，只能保持一个动词，其他变。好，我们看第二句，他每天搭公车去上班。
He goes to work by bus every day.
好，这个搭我们就用 goes 哈，这个 to work。那这个 by 哈，就是那个搭字哈。所以我们中文是两个动词搭跟去，可英文里面它只保留一个 goes， 那其他那个动词要用 by 介系词代替了。摇着尾巴，那只白狗朝他走来。
Wagging its tail, the white dog came up to him。
中文我们有两个动词，摇着尾巴还有走来。那我们翻成英文的时候，主要动词是 came 这个字，那个摇字怎么办呢？摇你就把它变成个分词哈，一个现在分词 wagging 这个字。好，我们再看，这项消息令他惊吓，他顿时脸色转为苍白。
Frightened by the news, he turned pale immediately.
我们看主要动词是 turned 这个动词。那另外一个这个惊吓怎么办呢？你要把它变成一个过去分词 frightened。好，主要的原则是一个动词就好了，其他的变化我们看下面。下面是例外情形啊，我们中文说我看到他过街了， 英文怎么说
？I saw him cross the road。
哎，你说这怎么会有两个动词的保留呢？因为我们看这个 saw 这个字哈，譬如原型是 see、feel、hear、smell、watch 等等这些感官动词，它后面的动词就要用原型哈，就 to 省略了。我们再看另外一个例外，我母亲叫我打扫客厅。
My mother had me clean the living room.
好，这是两个动词哦 ，had 还有 clean。因为 had 这个字是使役动词，譬如有 have 啦、let、make， 它后面的 to 也省略掉了哈，这是一个不同的地方。好，我们下面看这个时式 tense 的部分，中英文它表现的方式也不一样，我们来看看。他现在是位名小说家，我们要表示现在简单是怎么做？
He is a famous novelist.
好，这个意思就表现在了哈。那看有别的时间。他以前是位名演员。
He was a famous actor.
好，这 was 是过去式了哈。好，看看别的时态。他五年后会很有钱。
He will be very rich 5 years later.
好，未来式动词的变化哈。再来，我认识他已经五年了。
I have known him for 5 years.
这现在完成式哈，再来。我正在写信的时候，电话铃响了。
While I was writing a letter, the phone rang.
好，我们看一个是过去进行式，一个是过去简单式哈，这都是时态的不同。刚才介绍是动词在中英翻译的时候我们要注意的地方，现在来谈谈副词。副词在英语中它是用来修饰动词还有形容词其他副词，有时候修饰全个句子等等。其实我们汉语当中比较少用副词，那英语中的副词如形容词一样，它有比较级和最高级，我们汉语都加上比较或最这个词汇。我们来看这个表，请 Charles 老师帮我们念念看副词的原级、比较级还有最高级。
Fast, faster, fastest. Hard, harder, hardest. Happily, more happily, most happily.
都是副词哈。我们来举两个例子来试试看哈。
He pointed out some globally accepted ideas of beauty.
他提出一些普遍接受的美的观念。这个字是 globally， 是全球地哈，地球叫 globe， 那普遍地。可是我们翻成中文的时候，这地都副词没有翻出来，就说普遍就好了。所以有时候副词会把地省略掉。我们再看另一个例子。
How could you possibly expect me to do that？
你怎么能指望我做那件事？在英文里面有 possibly 可能地哈，这个我们几乎都没有放进去了。因为我们这样翻比较顺，放进去似乎是就不是那么顺的中文了。好，我们看看这个副词也是把它省略的状况。那我们先休息一下。除了副词以外，在中英翻译当中，冠词也有差异。冠词英文多半是这个名词前面会加 a 或者母音就 an， 或者是那是这个有不定冠词，它也有定冠词是 the the 哈。那在汉语当中就比较少，我们用一些实际例子来说明一下。
There was a large audience at the concert.
音乐会有许多观众，这个我们几乎都没有翻出来了哈，冠词不必翻了。
Her husband had an awful death.
她丈夫死得很惨，这个 and 我们也不翻。
I asked to see the manager.
这个 the 定冠词哈，我们也没有说 the 那个或这个，我们就说经理就好了，所以 the 也没翻出来。好，我们这个 a 或者 and 做量词的时候，那么在汉语里面译文要配合中文习惯来这个加上适当的量词哈，我们说明看看。
A horse.
一匹马。
An ox.
一头牛。
A house.
一栋房子。
A rope.
一条绳子。
An owl.
一只猫头鹰。
A table.
一张桌子。
A drama.
一出戏剧。
A cloud.
一片云。 所以我们看一下配合我们中文的这个量词的用一头一匹还怎么样，可英文都是一个 a 或者 an 哈，所以有不同。那么 Charles, what else about articles?
We use articles in front of official titles like the United States of America and names of oceans, rivers, mountains, sequence, years, etc. In Chinese, you don't have any equivalent to those articles.
对，我们没有这些冠词啊。老师说，英语中有一些称号啦，这个联邦啦、海洋啦、河流、山脉、序号、年代等等，那他们都会。用一些the 哈，有时候用形容词比较级或最高级，最高级都会用 the 哈来这个做一个说 the most beautiful 等等。那这个在汉语几乎都没有哈。我们用实例来看看好不好
？Her Majesty the Queen，
女王陛下，这 queen 前面加 the 了哈。
The Wangs，
the 加姓氏表示王室夫妇或者一家人。
The United States of America.
那是刚刚说过美利坚合众国。
The Atlantic Ocean.
这个海洋会加 the 哈。
The Yangtze River.
河流我没加 the。
The Himalaya or the Himalayan Mountains.
这喜马拉雅山，我们这个山脉加 the。
The first time.
第几次加 the。
The early 1960s.
这个年代我们会用的啊。
The smallest church.
我刚刚说最高级的时候哈、啊、，the smallest 要 the。好，这是我们今天学到重音，它在翻译的时候，动词、副词还有冠词有一些不同的地方要特别注意。现在看看 famous quotations 中外名言。滚石不生胎。
A rolling stone gathers no moss.
心有余而力不足。
The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
一针见血，说得中肯。
To hit the nail on the head.
小题大做。
To make a mountain out of a molehill.
收入仅够糊口。
To live from hand to mouth.
好，那这是我们今天的中外名言，中英给你对照一下。下面我们看看我们今天绘画的一些vocabulary and expressions 单字和片语。
Pinpoint，
准确地确定。
Exact，
确切的精确的。
Amazing，
令人惊讶。
Attend，
出席。
ENMU， Eastern New Mexico University。
东新墨西哥州大学。
Finishing touches，
最后的结束的工作。
MA degree，
硕士学位。
Every 2 weeks，
隔周。
Set to work，
开始工作。
Sundown，
日落。
Jab，
以尖东西刺戳。
Wrist，
手腕。
Sticking out，
突出。
Clinic，
诊所。
Family doctor，
家庭医师。
Landlord，
房东。
Get a shot，
注射。
Penicillin，
盘尼西林。
Tonsillitis，
扁桃腺炎。
Ex-classmate，
以前同学。
Rusty nail，
生锈的钉子。
Shake up，
骚动惊恐。
I'll say，
可不是吗。
Pray，
祈祷。
Touched，
受感动的。
Thoughtful，
细心的。
Prayer，
祷告。
Reaction，
反应。
Common practice，
普遍程序。
Mishap，
不幸事故。
Occur，
发生。
Evidently，
显然地。
Toxoid，
类毒素。
extract
提取物精
serum
浆液血清
a while
片刻
set out
出发
itch
痒
way out
遥远的
prairie
草原
Desert,
沙漠
swelling,
肿块
AKA, also known as,
别名
edema,
浮肿
gangrene,
坏疽
saw off,
锯掉
misinterpret,
误解
check into,
到达登记
Dormitory
宿舍
Dining hall
餐厅
Forehead
前额
Campus infirmary
校园医护室
Wedding ring
结婚戒指
Notch
凹口痕迹
Lie
躺卧
Operating table.
手术台
Antidote.
解毒剂。好，这是我们今天绘画的单字。那我们先看今天绘画的英文部分。
You can almost pinpoint the exact day after this long? Amazing!
Not really. Mom will attend ENMU at Portales every summer and put the finishing touches on her MA degree, coming back to Odessa every 2 weeks. She will arrive early Friday evening.
And since it was 202 miles, 325 kilometers, that means it would still have been light when she reached home.Then, so you said, you all set to work cleaning out the family car before sundown, and she got jabbed in the wrist by a small piece of metal sticking out of the front seat.
Tina and I accompanied her to Dr. Brian's clinic Saturday morning.
The same one who had been your family doctor when you first moved there and lived just a few steps from his office?
Yes, we walk across the yard behind our landlord's place to get a penicillin shot whenever we have tonsillitis.
But this was more serious. What she told you about her ex-classmate dying after stepping on a rusty nail must have shaken you up.
I'll say, when she failed to come out for what seemed like a long time, Tina and I both became extremely worried and prayed for her safe return.
She must have been touched to learn of her sweet children's thoughtful prayers.
That's how she put it.
Yet this reaction to the shot didn't happen right away. Nowadays, it's common practice to wait half an hour in case such a mishap occurs.
At that time, it evidently wasn't the case. The toxoid they used was an extract from horse's blood serum and took a while to react. She set out for Portales on Sunday, about mid-afternoon.And took to eating somewhere along the road.
Way out on the prairie, almost like a desert, with no one to help her. That swelling, aka edema, could have caused gangrene if her ring had been stuck on her finger too long. You said they had to saw it off?
Well, yes and no. I misinterpreted that part a little. She had checked into the dormitory and gone for supper in the dining hall when classmates noticed how red her forehead was getting.The swelling started a few minutes after that. She went to the campus infirmary, where a little saw was used to remove her wedding ring. She showed us the notch a couple of weeks later, after she got back to Odessa.
Yes, I recall how she'd been lying on an operating table when the doctor said it needed to be cut off. The antidote worked, though, and she slept in the dormitory that night. Happy ending.
好，那我们今天看这里，先休息一下。好，刚刚看是英文，我们现在来看一个 这中文的翻译部分。
You can almost pinpoint the exact day after this long. Amazing!
Not really. Mom will attend ENMU at Portales every summer and put the finishing touches on her MA degree, coming back to Odessa every 2 weeks. She will arrive early Friday evening.
And since it was 202 miles, 325 kilometers, that means it would still have been light when she reached home.Then, so you said, you all set to work cleaning out the family car before sundown, and she got jabbed in the wrist by a small piece of metal sticking out of the front seat.
Tina and I accompanied her to Dr. Brian's clinic Saturday morning.
The same one who had been your family doctor when you first moved there and lived just a few steps from his office?
Yes, we walk across the yard behind our landlord's place to get a penicillin shot whenever we have tonsillitis.
But this was more serious. What she told you about her ex-classmate dying after stepping on a rusty nail must have shaken you up.
I'll say, when she failed to come out for what seemed like a long time, Tina and I both became extremely worried and prayed for her safe return.
She must have been touched to learn of her sweet children's thoughtful prayers.
That's how she put it.
Yet this reaction to the shot didn't happen right away. Nowadays, it's common practice to wait half an hour in case such a mishap occurs.
At that time, it evidently wasn't the case. The toxoid they used was an extract from horse's blood serum and took a while to react. She set out for Portales on Sunday, about mid-afternoon.And took to eating somewhere along the road.
Way out on the prairie, almost like a desert, with no one to help her. That swelling, aka edema, could have caused gangrene if her ring had been stuck on her finger too long. You said they had to saw it off?
Well, yes and no. I misinterpreted that part a little. She had checked into the dormitory and gone for supper in the dining hall when classmates noticed how red her forehead was getting.The swelling started a few minutes after that. She went to the campus infirmary, where a little saw was used to remove her wedding ring. She showed us the notch a couple of weeks later, after she got back to Odessa.
Yes, I recall how she'd been lying on an operating table when the doctor said it needed to be cut off. The antidote worked, though, and she slept in the dormitory that night. Happy ending.
好，我们刚刚看了中文跟这个英文的这个部分，我们来做一些问题，看看你会不会答。
Question one: What is the main subject of this conversation? A. Health. B. Transportation. C. Religion. D. Academics.
A. Health.
Question two: What does the man imply about his mother?A. She survived an auto collision. B. She died while undergoing surgery. C. She holds an advanced degree. D. None of these.
C. She holds an advanced degree.
Question 3. Who is Tina? A. The woman's aunt. B. The man's sister. C. The man's wife. D. The woman's cousin.
B. The man's sister.
Question 4. What do we learn about the man? A. He will enroll in graduate school. B. He always wanted to be a teacher. C. He is now considering a divorce. D. He once lived in a dry climate.
D. He once lived in a dry climate. 好，这是我们今天的问题部分。我们下面来做一下 Let's Practice 句型翻译练习。
And since it was 202 miles, 325 kilometers, that means it would still have been light when she reached home.
因为距离为202英里325公里，所以她到家的时候天还是亮的。我们来学学看 since 由于既然，既然我们在城里，我们可以去看看他们。
Since we were in town, we could stop by and visit them. since we were in town, we could stop and visit them.
哪一个错了？
The second one's ungrammatical.
要 stop 就好了，不要一滴哈。好，我们另外做做看。
It was convenient to visit their place because we had arrived in town.
好，我们看下一句。既然时间还早，我们看场电影吧。
Since time is early, we can go to see a movie. Since it is early, we can go to see a movie.
哪一个错了？
The first one sounds like Chinglish.
中文式的英文，不要讲 time， 要讲 it。it 指 time 哈。好，另外翻翻看。
It's early enough for us to go watch a film.
好，我们看个例句。
Tina and I accompanied her to Dr. Brian's clinic Saturday morning.
星期六早上 ，Tina 和我陪她到布莱恩医师的诊所。我们要学 accompany， 陪伴、随同。他的哥哥陪他一起练习高尔夫球。
His brother accompanied him to practice golf. His brother accompanied him to practice the golf.
好，哪一个错了？
You don't need any article for golf there.
好，球类不必加 the 哈。来，我们看另外翻法。
He and his brother headed for the links together.
啊 ，links 是高尔夫球的意思。我们看下一句。根据天气预报，这场风暴将夹带大量雨水。
According to the weather forecast, the storm will be accompanied by heavy rain. According to the weather forecast, the storm will accompany heavy rain.
哪一个错了？
The second one changes the meaning.
哦，意思不对了。你要用被动式哈 ，be accompanied by。好，另外来翻翻看。
The weatherman tells us to expect torrential rains with this storm.
很好，我们开个例句。
She must have been touched to learn of her sweet children's thoughtful prayers.
倘若她知道她可爱的子女为她贴心的祈祷，肯定大受感动。我们来学 learn of， 获悉的意思。我们一得知球队赢得比赛，就马上开始庆祝。
We started to celebrate as soon as we learned the team won the game. We started to celebrate as soon as we learned of the team won the game.
哪一个错？
Second one sounds like Chinglish. You'd have to say of the team winning the game.
对，不能用 of 哈，后面加句子。来，另外翻翻看。
On hearing of our team's victory, we began celebrating.
好，我们下一句。我刚得知今天早上花莲地区发生强烈地震的消息。
I've just learned of the strong earthquake which hit the Hualien area this morning. I've just learned of the strong earthquake which hit the Hualien area this morning.
哪边有错呢？
Hit is an irregular verb, so it stays the same past or present.
好，它是 hit， 不能用 hit 哈。来，另外翻翻看。
A short time ago, I heard of this morning's tremor that shook Hualien.
好，同学，你们看到今天的课程里面教你很多中英翻译的不同的地方，要好好学一下。好，再见啦，下礼拜见，拜拜。